It was about a new way of providing service on the pan-European research internet. At the moment, we have a standard IP service, and if that's not performant enough for you, you build a private network. Now, a private network is fine if you've got a lot of capacity that you want to use, if you want to use it all the time. But if you have high demands, and you have those demands on a relatively occasional basis, then a private network is an expensive solution for you. At the same time, if you try and put lots of traffic onto the standard internet environment, you get congestion, and that doesn't work either. So what we have today is a lot of users who really would like a private network and are actually pushed into building a private network using our facilities, even though they don't use it very efficiently. And bandwidth on demand is a way of actually making that private network available when you want it for the period of time that you want it. It gives you dedicated resources, which the general purpose internet doesn't do, but it only gives them to you for the periods of time when you actually need them and when you want them. And so, if you like, it's a little bit like the old days of circuit switching, where you had a dedicated connection for the time that you needed it, and when you didn't need it, other people could use it. Given that the major investment in the internet is in sharing and competitive sharing, it's a technology that doesn't lend itself very easily to providing this sort of bandwidth on demand. And what we've done is to implement a combination of services using the transmission equipment and the routing equipment to actually carve out bandwidth on a dynamic basis. Most of the effort, it comes if you're doing this across multiple networks. If you do it in your own network, everything's more or less under your own control, and that's relatively straightforward. Once you start trying to do that across multiple networks, you start using other people's resources, and you have security issues. You also have to know what those resources are. So a lot of effort has gone into resource description in a uniform way across multiple networks. Then the other problem that you have to solve is that if you take five networks, you'll have six technologies involved. And each technology will be vendor specific. And so you need to have a layer of abstraction that provides a service independent of vendor technology. And that's the second area we've been working on. And I think I've shown in the presentation that if you put all that together, you have a service which is much more flexible than a private network, but much more controllable and dependable and reliable than the general purpose IP service.